Good morning to you all. Before coming to solar, I will just draw attention to the entire energy sector. Today, we have installed capacity of power 330,000 megawatts, out of which 57,000 megawatt is from renewables. If you take percentage, then it comes around 17% from renewables in a total energy portfolio. And this, now we come to a this, what is our targets? So that we very well know the targets for the country up to 2022 is 1,75,000 megawatt from renewables, out of which 100,000 megawatt is from solar, 60,000 megawatt from wind, 10,000 megawatt from biomass, and 5,000 megawatt from hydro. If we go by as usual, business as usual, then installed capacity by 2022 will be round about 5,55,000 megawatt, and the renewables will be around 1,20,000 megawatt, 1,75,000 megawatt. If we take this figure and the way progress is going on, it is expected that at least 5,55,000 megawatt, 5,25,000 megawatt will be the capacity by that time. And if we take 1,75,000 megawatt, then it will be 33% of the total energy portfolio, and which is from 17% now to 33%. Another report last week I read for a specific purpose, that was actually CA report, and beyond 2022, to 36, there is a 14-15 years plan. According to that, if we go by 2027, because they have taken a 5 years, and then last 3 years. By 27, this capacity will be 7,50,000 megawatt, and the renewables is expected to be 33% again. And thermal will come down to 52%, which is now today, it is 67%. And hydro almost constant to 12 to 13%. And if we go by further 32, then it is a 10,47,000 megawatt. And further go to 36, then it is a 13,37,000 megawatt. So this is the energy scenario in the country. With this now, coming to this, how actually our target is decided for renewables, then we have to go back little in number 15, where COP 21 in Paris was held, where the government of India or India has actually given some commitment, international commitment. That is what? That by 2030, we have to reduce our emission, carbon emission, by GDP of 2005 level to the extent to 33 to 35%. And the other point is, by 2030, the contribution from renewables should be 40%, though just minute before I said 33 by the CA report. Most likely CA report must have been prepared little 6-7 months back, so that they have put actually 33. Otherwise, it is a 40%, that is our target for the installed capacity. Of course, if you go by energy generation, that may be little less. Then, coming back to this, our now target is set. We have an international commitment, and now we have to plan accordingly. So now 175,000 megawatt the target right now. So take 100,000 megawatt, which is now today's topic, solar. So solar, this 100,000 megawatt, 100,000 megawatt, it is further divided into 60-40. 60,000 is to come from grid connected, and 40,000 megawatt is to come from solar rooftop. But the government further taken a decision because of the rooftop going slow, so that 20,000 megawatt has been reduced in the solar rooftop, and now it is added to the park. And it is a, this park, solar park scheme is really very nice, where the government, state government is taking care, or any other organization like NTPC or SECI. So there are number of parks, solar parks, and the infrastructure being developed by the state government. And then the, through reverse bidding method, the these bids are invited from the private developers, private or even a, the public sector companies. And now, because of this, the solar price, this cost of solar has come down drastically. That was 10 rupees 95 paisa in 2010, which is now came down to the level of 2 rupees 44 paisa. And if it is compared with the average average purchase of pooled price, then it is 33 paisa, 3 rupees 30 paisa. And if you compare, then 24% is lesser than the thermal power or power being purchased from the this all sources. So now there is a opportunity for us that we can go further, and the private developers, and there is a lot of opportunities in to invest in this sector. Now further, one more report I gone through last week, that was very interesting. Now that was actually in by 2018, the price of to the consumers, it is a 5 rupees 33 paisa, and few years later it will be 5 rupees 75 paisa. I think it is a 2022, and then further after 5-6 years it will be 7 rupees 50 paisa, and further it will be around 2030 or 2032 it will be around, expected to be around 10 rupees. And whereas price of solar is going continuously, maybe because of many other factors, some innovations also, maybe technological development also, because now throughout the world there is a research going on, and every day we are, or every now and then there is a announcement of the efficiency, cell efficiency, and of course then modules and overall power efficiency. So that definitely performance ratio of the solar power plant will further improve, and so on. And the price is expected, and the report says the solar price further may go down up to rupee 1 rupee 50 paisa. So though it looks 1 rupee 50 paisa is a very low, but the way price have fallen down over last 1.5 years, then nobody thought of that price will go so further. So I think it was 4 rupees 34 paisa in this Telangana or Andhra, Kurnool. And then it 315, then 330 it has come, 315 it has come, and then this Riva solar power project, that was 2 rupees 97 paisa in a first year, and thereafter 3 rupees 15 paisa or 30 paisa. And then further it surprises this 2 rupees 64 paisa, 60, and then further Badla 3 and 4, it is 2 rupees 44 paisa. It was now wondered how they are managing and how it will be done. So in fact, yesterday we have an internal training course, so we were just discussing, and then the trainer, PwC, they were asking ki how this. Then actually we have received the proposal, but not formally, not a application, but they have given a fair idea how actually they are achieving 2 rupees 44 paisa. That is precisely right. And yesterday one report I while in the flight I read in Economic Times that Andhra government from Kurnool, this power plant, solar power plant, they requested NTPC that they can take the power elsewhere, and they will not charge any transmission charges. So now this is the actually situation in the this market or regarding this energy. Now just coming to this, if you take this last year's generation, that is I think 1135 billion units from all sources, and if you take that per capita of our population 134 or close to very close to 135 crore, so then this per capita is coming around 1074 units. So it is still very, very less, actually far below with the average of world consumption, that is 3,000 or 3,000 units per capita. So now we definitely we have a lot of scope that we can increase per capita consumption, and definitely then it cannot be alone by the domestic this thing. Domestic is only 22 or 23%, whereas industrial is 44%. So we have to actually increase industries more and more. Actually we have to put industries, and that is also Government of India's scheme is there, that is a Make in India. So under that also lot of things happening, and we know I think $55 billion have been committed in this. So that is also huge money, and lot many industries are coming. So definitely this over the time power consumption will keep on increasing, and our hopefully this consumption will be not definitely for 3000 or world average, but at least 1500-1600 units per this per capita, and with this lot of opportunities actually come for. Now investment opportunities in solar specifically, then you see there are so many schemes starting with solar park, this grid connected large scale power projects, and now the power project sizes also has gone up actually, whereas a few years back means in 10-11 we have only done in 10 it was a 1 megawatt and 2 megawatt, and that was 100 megawatt was actually allotted, and only out of this 91 megawatt was installed. Through that also a huge generation based incentive, that was 12 rupees actually. Still we are my company IREDA is still administering that GVI at that rate since it is committed for 25 years. But definitely that program, a small program that actually gave a lot of seeding effect, and because of this so many, now we have reached to a such a big, large extent on this. And from that now 1 and 2 megawatt, that time that was also very, very means typical, whether it will perform, whether it will work. But from that also generation, if today we see it, I think comes around 12 to 13%, that is a less. But since then this lot many innovations have actually taken place, and this efficiency, overall efficiency has also increased, and now even most of the company, they are quoting a very high means CUF, that is as I think as higher as 27%. But that may be different reasons actually. There is a additional capacity DC side, and DC side, and then even a inverter also heavy duty, maybe instead of a standard design of 25% overloading, it may be 35-40% or 50% overloading. So with that, the efficiency is increasing overall, and that is one of the reason actually this the cost of generation is coming down. Now the opportunities, one is in this large grid connected, and other is the rooftop schemes, and there are off-grid applications also. And off-grid, I think one of the biggest program in pumping solar pump. Incidentally, that solar pump program actually long back, 20 years back when I joined IREDA in 94, I coordinated that program for 8 years, and during that time only we could install 7,100 pumps. But now that I don't know the exact number what is actually today installed capacity of solar pump, but I believe it is a Rajasthan alone is a 7,700. 35,000, and then plan this 10 lakh, actually 10 lakh is a 1 million solar pumps in this sanction process at various stages, and most likely I think the earlier this scheme being actually operated by NABARD, now the government is asking IREDA to again come back after we were up to 2007, I think we have operated that solar pump program, but at very low level. But now the solar pumps have also grown a much bigger size, and the new innovation is coming that why actually solar pump should we throw only the off-grid? Let it be a grid connected. So that will be further benefited to the farmers as and when power not required. But initially when the pump program was thought of, at the time it was thought that instead of a power you storing in the batteries, it should be stored in the what, in the form of water, and as and when you require water you can use it. But now that actually new this thing is coming, and if it is there then definitely it will further boost, and the pump program is very much beneficial to the state government, because now state government is subsidizing diesel pumps or electric pump. And electric pump that we know, there is a loss of transmission loss and so many loss, and all goes into the farmer's account. So that is very well. So now that state government are very much interested that this solar pump should come in a big way, and their budgetary support for subsidy should be reduced. Then another is this off-grid application is the mobile towers. There are lakhs of mobile towers throughout the country, and that actually towers can also be charged. In fact, we have also sanctioned a project of 600 towers in the state of UP, and out of that around 400 have already been completed, and this is really one of the good application. But incidentally, this mobile provider, they have given the only those towers which were they were not able to maintain, or where they were having a problem of diesel theft, etc. So those actually given instead of in urban area or something. Then another this off-grid application is this in a village electrification. So at the beginning of 2013-14, this 25,000 villages were unelectrified. Out of this, now I think 13,000 villages have already been electrified, 12,000 are still to be electrified. So there is also, again, it can be a mini grid. So I think REC is already operating through Dindayal Upadhyay Gramin Yojana. So that scheme is also exist. And further, there are energy access wherever it is not possible, those can be done. And further, the new the government has announced, or it is on on planning stage, that by 2030 we should move to electric vehicles. So if electric vehicles, so that is the opportunity for us to finance actually electric vehicles. And for you, this charging station, so those charging stations could be at highway sites, could be in urban areas, could be anywhere. So that actually another opportunity, and that could be one very big opportunity. Another opportunity is a petrol pump. I think in Assam, this Indian Oil has tied up with some manufacturers, and they are now dispensing units. They are using this solar application. So this is some opportunities in this sector. Now, for funding, now IREDA is in a very big way, we are funding, and now in last 3 years, we have funded 10,000, around 45% of our entire portfolio of 30 years. So that is the level actually we have gone up. And even last year, we have actually concluded year, 10,200 we have sanctioned, and 6,593 crore we have disbursed also. So this is actually, now solar roof specifically, now only Saturday I think government has, SECI has released the list of rooftops, that is a 5,000 5,000 something close to 500 close to in this RESCO model, and little less in the this RESCO model, and other is a CAPEX model. So now I don't know, now their budget is for only 500 this thing. So the, how it will be decided? Out of this, Telangana is I think got 9 megawatt in RESCO mode. 8 point something and 0.9 or something in this CAPEX model. So 9 megawatt capacity is already for Telangana. So whoever operating in this area, for them this is a good business. And otherwise also, if without this also definitely can go. Then this RPO obligations. That RPO obligation is also 8% for solar and 9% of non-solar, other renewable energy. So that also makes sense, or that will also make further opportunities that will actually, though today it looks on paper that this plan will go this way, that way. But this RPO, at least the state governments are bound to actually do something, and they have to achieve this RPO obligation, so they have to do. And I think I will not take much more time, and I'll stop here. So thank you very much for patience hearing. So area for them, this is a good business, and otherwise also, if without this also definitely can go. Then this RPO obligations, that RPO obligation is also 8% for solar and 9% of non-solar, other renewable energy. So that also makes sense, or that will also make further opportunities that will actually, though today it looks on paper that this plan will go this way, that way. But this RPO, at least the state governments are bound to actually do something, and they have to achieve this RPO obligation, so they have to do. And I think I will not take much more time, and I'll stop here. So thank you very much for patience hearing.